गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, द पार्ट फोर्थ ऑफ द चैप्टर स्टेट्स ऑफ मैटर इज डाल्टन्स लॉ ऑफ पार्शियल प्रेशर. दिस लॉ वॉज फॉर्मुलेटेड बाय जॉन डाल्टन इन 1801 एंड इट स्टेट दैट डाल्टन्स लॉ स्टेट्स दैट द टोटल प्रेशर एक्सर्टेड बाय अ मिक्सचर ऑफ नॉन रिएक्टिव गैसेस इज इक्वल टू the sum of the partial pressure of individual gas. Now here the term partial pressure is used. The meaning of the partial pressure is, for example, we have a container and this container is full of gases. We kept various type of gases inside this container. So each gas has a tendency to exert the pressure to the wall of the container. So the pressure exerted by individual gas is known as the partial pressure. Pressure exerted by the individual gas is known as the partial pressure. So according to this law, the total pressure exerted by the mixture of a gas, for example, this is a mixture of a gas, is equal to the sum of the partial pressure of the individual gases. The pressure which these gases would exert if they were enclosed separately in a same volume under the same condition of temperature. So in a mixture of gases, the pressure exerted by the individual gas is called the partial pressure, and it is mathematically expressed as, for example, this is P total. P total means the total pressure is equals to the P1 plus P2 plus P3 up to dot dot. So P1, P2, P3, for example, here are 1, 2, 3 gases whose one has the pressure P1, second has the pressure P2. So total pressure is equal to P1, P2 plus P3 means the partial pressure of the gases which are kept inside this container. Now, gases are generally collected over water, and therefore they are moist. So the pressure of a dry gas can be calculated by subtracting the vapor pressure of water from the total pressure of the moist gas, which contain water vapor also. So pressure exerted by saturated water vapor is called the aqueous tension. The pressure exerted by the saturated water vapor, or the pressure exerted by the water vapor, is known as the aqueous tension. So now the next topic related to the Dalton's law of partial pressure is partial pressure in terms of mole fraction. This is our next topic. Partial pressure in terms of mole fraction. Now suppose T is the temperature and at temperature T, three gases are enclosed in the volume V, and V is the volume. T is the temperature, V is the volume. Exert partial pressure P1, P2 and P3. At temperature T, we enclose the three gases inside a vessel whose volume is V, and the gases exert the pressure as P1, P2 and P3 respectively. So we have the formula, that is P1 is equal to, this is a small p, make it a small p, P1 is equal to N1 RT upon V. Here the number of the mole of the gases are different, pressure exerted by the gas is different, R is the constant, V and T both are the constant. So same as that, P2 is equal to N2 RT upon V, and P3 is equal to N3 RT upon V. Now we have the different equations for the P1, P2 and P3. Where N1, N2 and N3 are the number of mole of these gases. So for the total pressure, if we want to find out the P total, so the P total is equal to, we already have written the formula, that is the P1 plus P2, that is plus P3. So N1 RT upon V plus N2 RT upon V plus N3 RT upon V. So this is for the P total. This value is for the P total. Now N1 plus N2 plus N3. Write it like this. NRT upon V. It is common in all the three terms. So this is N1 plus N2 plus N3. These are the number of moles of gases. And that is RT. R is the gas constant, T is the temperature, and V is the volume. Now, on dividing P1 by P total, we get, when we divide P1 by P total, we get the value of P1 is, that is N1 RT upon V. So P1 upon P total is equal to N1 plus N2 plus N3, and here that is RTV and RTV. Now this is cancelled. So we have N1 upon N1 plus N2 plus N3, and it is equal to N1 upon N. So here we use the term N, means N is equal to, let us suppose, N1 plus N2 plus N3, and this N1 upon N is equal to X1, and X stand for the mole fraction. We have already discussed about the mole fraction in the chapter 1, that it is equal to the number of moles of solute to the total number of moles which is present in the solution. For example, this is a solution and this is the one solute which is present in the solution. So this is the mole, this one is the mole fraction. Here X1 is the mole fraction of the gas. Therefore P1 is equals to X1 P total. We have this formula, that is P1 upon P total is equal to X. So P1 is equal to X1 P total. So this is the Dalton law of partial pressure in terms of the mole fraction. Now the next topic is kinetic molecular theory of the gases. This theory is also known as the microscopic model. And why it is termed as a microscopic model? Because this theory is based on the microscopic particle. Here the meaning of the microscopic particle is atoms or the molecule present in the gases. This theory was put forward by Bernoulli and was further developed and extended by Clausius, Maxwell, Boltzmann and others. The microkinetic molecular theory has various postulates. Let us discuss one by one. Okay, the first postulate is all the gases are made up of very large number of extremely small identical particles, and these particles are known as the atoms or molecules. So every gas possesses the tiny particles, they are the atoms and the molecule. This is the first postulate. The second postulate is the molecules are separated from one another by large distance. There is a large distance in between the atom and the molecule of the gases, and the empty space among the molecule are so large that the actual volume of the molecule is negligible as compared to the total volume of the gases. This is the second postulate. Now the third postulate is the molecule are in the state of random motion. It means that if you kept gases in any container. So the molecule are in the random motion. The meaning of the random motion means the atom collide with each other as well as they collide with the wall of the container. Now the next is the molecular collision are perfectly elastic. Now the meaning of the perfectly elastic is no loss of energy occurs when the molecule collide with one another or with the wall of the container. However, there may be redistribution of energy during the collision process. Now the next is there are no force of interaction. Interaction means nor repulsive and neither attractive between the molecules at ordinary temperature and pressure. They move completely independent of one another. Now the next postulate is the pressure exerted by the gas is due to the collision of its molecule on the wall of the container. And the last postulate is the average kinetic energy of a gas molecule is directly proportional to the absolute temperature. So these are the postulates of the kinetic molecular theory. I will send these postulates with the help of PDF to you. Now the next topic is behavior of real gases, deviation from the ideal gas equation. We all know very well that the gases which follow the ideal gas equation, that is the Avogadro law, Charles law and the Boyle's law, are known as the ideal gases, or ideal gases are also known as the perfect gases. However, none of the actually known gases obey this equation over the entire range of the temperature and pressure. Now the next term is the, that is deviation from the ideal gas equation. Now if any gas doesn't follow the ideal gas equation, so this is known as the deviation from ideal gas equation, and these gases are known as the real gases. Real gases. So the gases which does not follow the ideal gas equation, that is PV is equal to nRT, are known as the real gases, and real gases are also known as the non-ideal gases. Real gases show ideal behavior when condition of temperature and pressure are such that the intermolecular forces are practically negligible. The real gases show ideal behavior when pressure approaches to the zero. So this deviation from the ideal behavior can be measured or can be expressed in terms of compressibility. Compressibility factor, and it is designated by Z. The compressibility factor is designated by Z, and it is expressed as it is a ratio of the product of pressure and volume. It is the ratio of the product of pressure and volume and the nRT, that is nRT. So Z is equal to PV upon nRT. So this is the expression for the compressibility factor. So for ideal gases, if we have any ideal gas, Z is always equals to 1 at all temperature and pressure. Because, and what is the reason? Because we know that PV is equal to nRT. So if the value of Z is 1, so PV is equals to the nRT. So this is the value of Z for the ideal gases. At high pressure, all the gases have the value Z is greater than 1. these are more difficult to compress at intermediate range at intermediate range of pressure at intermediate range of pressure most gases have the value z is less than a 1. Thus gases show ideal behavior when the volume occupied is large so that the volume of the molecule can be neglected in comparison to it. So this is the deviation. This is the deviation from the ideal gas equation, and these topics are all about the real gases or the behavior of real gases. In other words, the behavior of the gas become more ideal when pressure is very low. It means that the gas act as an ideal gas. Any gas act as a shows the ideal behavior when the pressure is very low. So up to what pressure a gas will follow the ideal gas law depend upon the nature of the gas and its temperature. So the temperature at which the real gas obey ideal gas law over an appreciable range of pressure is called the Boyle's temperature, and it is also known as the Boyle's point. So the Boyle point of a gas depend upon its nature, and above their Boyle point, real gases show positive deviation from the ideality and Z value. Z means the compressibility factor. Z value are greater than 1. The force of attraction between the molecule are very feeble. Below Boyle's temperature, real gases first show decrease in Z value, compressibility factor value, with increasing pressure, which reaches a minimum value on further increase in the pressure. The value of Z increases continuously. So these are the different range of the compressibility factor at the high temperature and at the intermediate temperature. So if Z is less than 1, so it is known as the negative. It is called negative deviation. It is known as the negative deviation, and it means that the gas is more compressible. The gas is more compressible. The gas is more compressible than expected from ideal behavior. And the second term is, if Z is greater than 1, this is the another value. If Z is greater than 1, so it is called the positive deviation. It is called positive deviation. It is called positive deviation, and it means that gas is less compressible. Gas is less compressible. In case of the negative deviation, the gas is more compressible, while in case of the positive deviation, the gas is less compressible than expected from ideal behavior. So these are the compressibility factor. Now the last topic of this chapter is the thermal energy. The thermal energy is the energy of a body due to the motion or the movement of its atom or the molecule. It is the energy because of the motion of the atom or movement of the atom or the molecule, and it is directly proportional to the temperature of the substance. The thermal energy is directly proportional to the temperature of the substance, and it is measured of average kinetic energy of a particle of the matter, and therefore it is responsible for the movement of the particle, because we know that kinetic energy is due to the motion. If the kinetic energy arises due to the motion, so this movement of the particle therefore also called the thermal motion, the motion, because it at this energy create arise because of the motion. So this motion is also called the thermal motion, and keep the molecule apart. This thermal motion keeps the molecule apart. Now if we want to know about the intermolecular forces versus the thermal energy of three state of matter, so under this heading a substance may exist in the three state. We all know very well the three state. We have already earlier we have discussed that the three state of matters are solid, liquid and the gases. So in the gases, the molecule have the weakest means negligible, near about the negligible molecular interaction. It means that there is no interactive or the there is no attractive forces, but highest thermal energy, but they have the highest thermal energy. Therefore the molecule in the gas can move at a random in all the direction with high speed, because we know very well that thermal energy is because of the motion. So there is no interaction or there is no attractive force in between the molecule of the gases, so the molecule of the gases are freely to move here and there, so its thermal energy is very high. But in case of the solid, the molecule interaction are stronger. There is no interparticular space in between the particle or the atom. So its thermal energy is weakest. If we compare the three state of the matter, so the weakest thermal energy is in the solid, and therefore the molecule in the solid have no translatory motion and can only oscillate with respect to their equilibrium position. Therefore the solid can have only the vibratory motion. Now in case of liquid, the two type of energies are intermediate between the solid and the gases. So some of the property of the solid, liquid and gases can be explained on the basis of the intermolecular forces and the thermal energy. As we have learned in the intermolecular force, the intermolecular forces tend to keep the molecule together, while the thermal energy tends to keep the molecule apart from each other. So in liquid state, there is a balance between attractive intermolecular forces and thermal motion. So the molecule can have translatory motion but cannot become completely free like the gases, because there is a little bit interaction between the particles. So in solid and the liquid, molecule cannot be pushed together by the external pressure, because the intermolecular forces become repulsive at a small distance between the molecule. Therefore the solid and liquid cannot be easily compressed. Only a small change in the volume occur on their interconversion from solid to liquid and vice versa. So the breaking and the making of the bond between the molecule in the liquid give it a non-rigid structure. We know that the liquid has a non-rigid structure. So why? The reason behind the non-rigid structure is the breaking and the making of the bond between the molecule. So this explains as to why liquid do not have any definite shape. This is the explanation for it, why liquid doesn't have a definite shape, although they have a definite intermolecular interaction energy between the molecule. And in gases, there are large empty space. We all know very well the gases particle are far apart from each other, and these can be readily compressed when the pressure is applied. When we apply a pressure, we can easily compress the gas. The gas possesses the high compressibility nature, hence the gases are highly compressible. That is the reason, because the interparticle or interatomic distance is very high, that's why they are easily compressed.